the MIT Center for Advanced Virtuality. You could look at it as a way to investigate how we can blend the imagination with the physical world. A lot of our work involves simulating social phenomena, such as discrimination in the workplace, bias within the classrooms, how we see each other in different circumstances, depending on our background, ways that we are categorized. How can we use these simulations to spark the imagination, to spark perspective transformation? We've done work on issues of everyday discrimination, sometimes called microaggression, using video gaming as a platform for addressing this kind of issue. Our work also addresses issues like personalization. Sometimes people might have a sense of needing to be pushed in a certain kind of area to be challenged. Sometimes people need to be scaffolded and supported, and to have technologies that can do either as needed, I think, is a kind of crucial advance.
The future of rich educational experiences, interactive communications in a post-pandemic world where remoteness is ever more important and where the technologies to support that are multiplying, this center on an integrated basis can, with students and faculty and tapping all corners of MIT, be a critically important, significant contributor to that thinking.
We are gratified to receive an Emmy Award for interactive documentary. This particular work is called In Event of Moon Disaster, and it's a project that constructs a deep fake of Richard Nixon giving the speech that he would have given if the moon landing had been unsuccessful.
Fate has ordained that the men who went to the moon to explore in peace.
It's actually a beautiful and elegiac speech, but it was never given. It's computer generated using machine learning techniques.
To explore in peace. We'll stay on the moon.
This is a project which helps people to understand, how do we recognize this kind of technology? Can we recognize this kind of technology? It's really a form of learning that you could say responds to the particular culture, not just of the subject matter, but of the user of the system as well. And I think that's just a hallmark of a kind of broader approach in learning in which we can personalize and customize experiences. There is not just one truth. And by seeing the same story through different lenses, that broader message can emerge. Helping to build this studio and lab that uses simulation and technologies of virtuality for the social good and inventing new forms of learning that's engaging and immersive, I would say that that's the key towards pushing our agenda forward.